fisher just says, man, I'm fishing. I just fish. That's what I do. That's what I do. And he went to the backyard pond to make his decision, and we'll know what that decision was in a few minutes.
Program the right way. He's been a leader the right way. He's a good God-fearing kid. He was raised the right way. So He plays hard, so we're really proud of him and everything that he's achieved so far for himself and for his family and for Evans and for our community. So, we're really happy for you, man. We're excited for you. We just need you to pick the right hat, hopefully somewhere along the line. Thank y'all, Coach Music, Coach Bill. Thank y'all for all that you do for our program. Thank y'all for supporting this young man. Y'all spend a lot more time with him in the hallways and everything like that. Thank you for all our teachers. Thank you for our front office staff, our Board of Education. So thank you to these four sitting up here for everything you've done for us. I'm going to bring up what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to tell one more story, and I'm going to bring up Ryan. But I still remember 3 years ago, he came running back by the office because he had just got some interest from Louisville. So he got some interest from Louisville. He comes back there banging on the door, and he comes back there, and he said, Coach, I'm supposed to call Louisville here in about 10 minutes. He said, I don't know how to talk to this person. He said, I don't know. What am I supposed to say to Coach? What do they want from me? I said, just go talk to him, be yourself, and you'll be fine. And so it's been cool to see somebody who's nervous as a 14-year-old coming in to how he's grown throughout the process and, has remained humble through the whole thing. So, it's cool to see that process happen. So, proud of you, man. So, all right, Ryan, I'll bring you up.
I've got a little Bill story, too.
Good.
No, it's funny because one of my best friends is the offensive coordinator at Louisville. And so when Mason sat down, Mason almost ended up on a baseball scholarship. He started talking about baseball, and he said, yeah, I play baseball too, And he didn't know what to say. He was so nervous. I think about when we went up to Notre Dame. You're getting ready to go into the ninth grade. This big kid walking in and just the eyes of everybody looking at you, man, and you learning how to respond to that throughout this time. To echo what Coach said, he's just such a great kid, too. A great young man, I want everybody to understand, when you're going through the things that Mason's going through, he can't hide anywhere, right? He's so big. He's always had that. But he's had to learn how to deal with those things, too, And as you see young men go through success, when you see young men go through success like this, they a lot of times we just see the hat pick day, the pictures of being on the sidelines, at Clemson and Georgia and all these other wonderful places. But you don't think about the 5 a.m. mornings of this young man deciding to choose to do the right things and get up. Big doesn't get you there to where he's talking about going and what he wants to do and what these programs are looking for him to do at the next level. It's about being a great man. And it was so neat to hear both, on the trips that I went to, with Clemson and Georgia, to be able to hear them talk about, hey, for us to have a leader like this, coming into our offensive line, that's what we're hungry for. It's the fact that he's not just got the size, it's the footwork, and it's the character, and it's the leadership. And so we're all so proud of you, Mason. At 5 a.m. the other morning, I sent him this verse. It was my training verse, and Romans 12, 1 and 2. But it talks about in 12:1 to offer your body up as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to the Lord, and that's your living act of worship. And that's what I see him doing. He's sending me pictures all the time of him and the team. And I always fall down on the box, right? But putting in that work, Hey, I'm over here. It's 10:30 at night during the summer. I'm in your gym down here working out. Just want to let you know. You know what I mean? That's pretty awesome. He's not doing other things that he could have been doing, wasting time, but really pouring into himself. But the other part of that verse, and two, is to not conform to the ways of this world, but to be transformed by the renewing of your mind. What a person thinks they truly become. And with Mason, that's just one of the neat things. On that Notre Dame trip, I came back, we went back and forth, and you were like, thank you so much for pouring into him. But I was like, wow, I'm admiring this young man. that wants knowledge, that wants to know. He's just different, you know? And it's okay to be different in a world that, you know, it's all about being different. Doing the right thing is the different thing to do, you know? So let's pray real quick, and then we'll let Mason chew the hat. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for the opportunity that Mason has today, the fact that we all get to come in here and be able to experience this with him. We thank you for the talent that you've graced him with, Father. Let everyone in this room continue to pray for Mason as he goes through the difficulties and the challenges that are ahead. There's going to be great times, there's no doubt, but there's a lot of grind out there in front of him, and let us be praying for that. Thank you for all that his family has done to pour into him from his childhood, for his coaches who have poured into him here, for what Evans High School has meant to him. Lord, thank you for the way that he responds and receives instruction. Lord, I just pray for the school that he chooses, that when he gets there, that they truly know what they have in front of them, and that they equip him with everything that he needs to go in and continue to become all that you created him to be. Let us continue to pray for him. Let us continue to think of him. And let us enjoy seeing the fruits of his labor poured out onto the football field and using his platform to do good things. And that's what he really wants to do. Give him favor, God. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
My roots in this community go so deep. My dad played high school ball here, my brother as well. My family in this area is just not my blood. You know, I have so many people that helped me. I couldn't do what I did without it. These are my brothers over here. Been grinding since we were from middle school. I couldn't be nothing without my teammates and coaches. It's just been all a blessing. I'm so humbled by this process. I couldn't do nothing without God. I would not be up here today, I'll tell you that, but there's been a lot of nights I've been thinking about, this is not for me, and all it takes is just one break of prayer in a Sunday in church. My faculty and staff, my coaches, by golly, I would not be here, that's for a fact, but I have my teachers. They help me a lot. Struggle in some classes, I have some teachers that help me stay after class, and to my coaches, all those times we had in summers, might not get it right. Could try to yell at me a little bit too bad. But just gotta take on the chin and continue, stay tough. The vision's clear, the tunnel's straight. That's what you gotta do throughout this whole process. That's what I've done. Just block out everything else and maintain focus. But that being said, all this family here, and again, I appreciate everyone has work, families they could be at right now and making money and eating breakfast. I appreciate y'all being here. That being said, I'll be continuing my athletic and academic career at
Joanna!